Hello, and welcome to another edition of Mr. Chappell's Chemistry Screencasts. Today, we're going to learn about doing calorimetry problems. What you'll learn today is, well, no surprises, how to solve calorimetry problems in chemistry. Now, there are a couple of things that you're going to need. You're going to need a calculator, of course, and you're going to need a list of specific heats. Now, you can find this in your textbook with a little bit of looking up. Let's go ahead and get started. Well, here we are, and this is the equation that we need to know to be able to solve calorimetry problems. And it goes something like energy is equal to the mass, m equals the mass, times the specific heat, times T final minus T initial. This is delta T. This is the change in temperature. Now, the mass you're probably familiar with, and temperature you're probably familiar with. Specific heat is a measure of a substance's ability to absorb or release energy. So let's go ahead and try a problem. Okay, so here we are, and we're asked how much energy must be added to 1500 grams of water to raise its temperature from 25 to 75 degrees Celsius. Well, the first thing I want to do is I want to go ahead and write down the equation that I'm going to apply. Energy is equal to mass times the specific heat times T final minus T initial. It's always a good idea to start out by writing down your equation. It helps fix it in your mind. And at least in Mr. Chappell's class, it's good for at least a point of partial credit. And let's go ahead and start. And the mass we are given is 1,500 grams. And the specific heat for water, now this is a value that I happen to know off the top of my head, but I would always give this value too if you need it in a problem. We're not in the business of memorizing physical constants. And the value for water is 4.189, and that's in joules per gram degrees Celsius, times the final temperature, which is 73 degrees Celsius, minus 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, before we do anything, let's just make absolutely certain that our units are going to cancel. And grams cancels here. And you'll notice the degrees Celsius cancels as well. And the only unit that we have left standing is the joule unit. And my calculator gives me the value of 30168 joules. Now, obviously, I don't get to report all those digits. I'm constrained by significant figures. So the first number has two significant figures. The second one has four. And when we do the difference between these two, the result has two. So I think we're only allowed two significant figures. So I'll write this number as 3.0 times 10 to the power of, and let's count that decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 joules. And that's how you do it. Okay, for our next problem, I've made it a little bit more complicated. And in this problem, we're given the energy, but we're asked to figure out what the mass is. So let's go ahead and write down our equation that we're going to apply. Energy is equal to mass times specific heat times the quantity, the final temperature, minus the initial temperature. And let's go ahead and solve for the mass. And to do that, what I'm going to do is divide the right-hand side by the specific heat. And the change in temperature. Well, if I do it on the right-hand side, I'm going to have to do it to the left-hand side as well. And so on the left-hand side, I'll write down specific heat times the change in temperature. And specific heats cancel. And this whole quantity will cancel for us. Now I'm going to rewrite the equation and clean it up just a little bit. And I get the mass is equal to, downstairs I'm going to have the specific heat times the change in temperature. And that's going to be all over the energy. So now what I need to do is to plug in my numbers. And I'll go ahead and put in the specific heat first. And again, I don't give it to you in this problem because I kind of expect you'll be able to look it up. But this is water, so the specific heat is 4.189, and that's joules per gram degrees Celsius. And the change in temperature is from 85 degrees Celsius minus 25 degrees Celsius. And upstairs, we're going to go ahead and put the energy. And the energy is 5,500. And that's in joules. Now, I want to stop and just make absolutely certain that my units are going to work out. And the joule unit cancels here. And degrees Celsius cancels here. And the only unit that we have left standing is the gram unit, which is the units of our answer. And it's downstairs, and like I explained at class, being downstairs is the same as being upstairs. And the answer I get is 21.882, blah, 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 blah. It keeps on going, and I get the units as grams. Well, I'm not allowed all those sig figs. So our energy has 2 sig figs, and our temperature difference has 2 sig figs, and we got 4 in our specific heat. So we're only allowed 2 sig figs in our final answer. And so that's going to end up being 22 grams, because that 1 is actually closer to a 2, because there's an 8 behind it. Okay, this is our last problem. And we're being asked to figure out what the specific heat is. So again, I'm going to go ahead and write down my equation. Energy is equal to mass times specific heat times the change in temperature. Now, you'll notice this time that they don't give us a final and initial temperature. It just tells us what the difference is right off the bat. So I'm going to call this delta T. Well, that'll make solving this just a little bit easier. So what I'm going to need to do is divide both sides by mass times the change in temperature. Mass cancels and delta T cancels, and I'm left with the specific heat is going to be equal to, downstairs I've got the mass times the change in temperature, and upstairs I have the energy. So all I need to do now is to go ahead and plug in my numbers. Our mass is 1500 grams. The change in temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. And the amount of energy that's added is 4,500 joules. Now, we can check our units, but you'll notice that absolutely nothing cancels here. We're stuck with all the units. And that's not surprising because it's a specific heat, and those have 3 units in them. And the number my calculator gives me is 0.21428, blah, 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 and that's in joules per gram degrees Celsius. Well, we got to go back and consider sig figs. And if you look at the question, 2 sig figs is going to be all that we're allowed. And so the answer is 0.21 joules per gram degrees Celsius. And that's our final answer. Well, it's joke time once again. Hey, did you know that no matter how much you push the envelope, it'll always be stationary?